Hello friends, I am Dr. Fatima and you are watching the Mom School. Today we are going to discuss a very important topic which will answer a lot of your queries as parents which pop up in your mind, especially related to your child's behavior. Like, why does my child throw food or toys or anything as a matter of fact? Why is he or she so naughty? Or the other thing is that we plan so many activities, we buy so many toys, but our child doesn't use them or doesn't engage with them. So what do we do? Okay, to understand all these things and the mystery of child behavior, there is one very important concept which parents should know, and I'm really grateful that I came across this concept, because it is helping me really as a mother. So this concept is called a schema. Okay, and schema in child behavior refers to the repeated action which children make. Okay, from within they have an urge to do an action over and over again. Okay, and that's their way of doing trial and error. They are like little explorers or scientists who are doing their trial and error and figuring about unknown, which is the world around them. Okay, many a thing they see others doing, but they want to do things themselves and figure out how the world operates and how things in the world operate. Okay, so that's an unnatural urge which comes from within, and the behavior pattern which they show is called schema. Okay, more or less many children show similar kind of behavior pattern, okay, which is unique to each child, which is not necessarily that if my child is 18 month old, he or she will be in the same schema as your child who is 18 month old. Schema or behavior is unique to each child. Any child can show at any age interval, as in at any age time. But what is important as parent is to be aware, so that we can understand our child's behavior and plan the activities and deal with situations accordingly. So there are basically 8 types of schemas, okay, which don't follow any particular sequence when they happen with a child. Any 2 schemas can be operating at the same time, or a child might be going through any 1 schema at a time, or more than 2 or 3 schemas at a time. So what are these schemas? So to make it easy, I'm using an abbreviation, tree top connection. Okay, the starting letters of tree top will make the starting 7 schemas, and the last connection is the last connecting schema. So there are total 8 schemas. Let me walk you through each of them one by one. So the first schema is called T trajectory schema, which is the schema or pattern of behavior which children show, in which they are trying to figure out how things move about in the air. Like, your child is throwing food not to irritate you. The child is trying to figure out, what if I throw food, where will it land? Now if I throw with this much force, where will it land? Okay, what will happen to this food item? See, it's their scientific nature which is urging them from within to do these things. Okay, now what as a parent you can do? As a parent, you're not supposed to encourage, of course, throwing of food or any other toy. Okay, so we have to redirect their behavior. If you see that your child is running through air, okay, or moving in the air, moving a lot, okay, and trying to climb up and down a thing, okay, or throwing things and food, then you can understand that, okay, my child is going through trajectory schema. He or she has an urge to explore how things move in the air. So let me play with him or provide him with balls. Okay, so we have to redirect the behavior into something which can engage the child, engage that schema, and is safe for the child, and is also discipline-wise okay for the child to do. Like, maybe you can arrange an indoor slide, okay, or you can take them to outdoor slide if that is possible right now, or you can play run and catch with them, or you can create some pillow or tower or something in which they can climb, or you can give them pom-pom balls to throw, or you can give them some magnetic darts to throw. So this is the way in which they can explore the trajectory or path of objects through air. So we have to redirect the behavior and tell them, no, no, the food is not for throwing. Food is for, instead, what I do with my child, I say food is for eating and ball is for throwing. Okay, so that makes it clear in their mind. Still, they will be repeating it because they have that urge from within, and our job as parent is to keep on redirecting their behavior. So this was the first and very important schema, which is trajectory schema. One more thing that this schema can be seen in babies, in toddlers, in very young children as well, and in young children as well. Okay, so it doesn't follow, as I said, a sequence or something. It is observed in children of different age groups. Now coming to the second schema, which is rotational schema. R for rotational schema. In rotational schema, children like to imitate or see objects which spin or roll. Okay, they like to play with objects which spin and roll. So they are trying to figure out how things spin and roll, and what is this, how they can roam about round and round. So they are exploring the circling, spinning and rolling motion of objects. So what you will observe is that the child will try to open or close the caps, or the child will try to move or about or run in circles. Okay, this kind of thing, anything in which the child is trying to, or if the washing machine is rotating, the child will try to concentrate there. Okay, will stick around there. So you can figure out that the child is being fascinated by rotating or rotational movements. So that means that a child has an urge to observe and explore rotation, rolling, spinning kind of things. So what as parents we can do is that we can provide them with opportunities in which they can roll and spin. Of course, again, there is ball, okay, it rolls, but spinning is also very important. So we can give them tops, okay, in which they can roll, or you can help them roll it, and you can hold their hands and make them move in circles. That's the most, you know, favorite activity of my child, going round and round holding my hand, okay, in rotational schema. And you can plan toys also which can do rotational movements. Now coming to the next schema, which is enveloping schema. E for enveloping schema. In envelop means you have to cover them completely. In this schema, the child is trying to make things disappear or hide under something or inside something. Okay, they are seeing what if they cover the thing, what will happen. Okay, so like my child, I figured out when he was in this, he still is in enveloping schema. So the child was trying to cover himself with the blanket, trying to wear his clothes, cover his hands in, put his hands inside the cup to cover it in the milk or water, whatever is in the cup. Okay, so the basic thing is that they are trying to cover things up. Okay, so they might put things inside the basket and close the basket, then open again and take it out again, put it. So they are trying to envelop things or cover things. So you can play peekaboo, hide and seek with them. You can provide them with baskets in which they can put on things, put inside of it, okay, things or any other objects. So you can give them play scarf, which you can play peekaboo. So this kind of activities you can engage your child in. Okay,